declare, get yourself and be broken in pieces. Assemble yourself from the east, north, south, and west and be broken in pieces. Take your counsels in the regions of the sea and it shall come to naught. Speak your word and it shall not stand, for God is with us.
Voice of Inspiration is sponsored by Budget Cash and Carry, official distributors of Hallelujah Non-Alcoholic Sparkling Wine.
Have you read that has changed your life? Visit Dominion Bookshop and discover a unique collection of life-transforming books, including The Price of Greatness, Divine Timing, Destined to Make an Impact, and lots more, all written by Archbishop Duncan Williams. Also in stock are other great books authored by men of God with great experiences that would impact your life. Dominion Bookshop is located at the Prayer Cathedral, Christian Action Faith Ministries International, off the Sprinters Road.
Praise the Lord. From the Archbishop Duncan Williams, you can now receive inspirational calls and SMS on your mobile phones wherever you may be.
How? Tell me more.
Just subscribe to receive daily messages on your mobile phones by texting Ariba 1486, OneTouch 1686, Kasapa 1786, and Tigo 1886.
Join the family now, because your future is in the making.
Bless you. Be inspired. Be motivated. Unlock your potential and walk into your destiny.
Bible says in 1 Chronicles, the 12th chapter and the 32nd verse, he said, and of the sons of Issachar, who were men, not boys, but men. That is one of the problems we have in the body of Christ today. We have so many boys trying to be men. And that's why the Bible said, for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother. He didn't say a boy, because boys are dependent, but men are independent. And of the sons of Issachar, who were men that had understanding. Somebody say understanding. Understand. Somebody say understanding. Understand. Say it again. Say understanding. Understand. Say one more time. Understanding. Understand. Who were men that had understanding of the times. Say the times. Everybody say it again. Say the times. Say the times. Now you got to understand something, ladies and gentlemen, that there were so many other tribes apart from the tribes of Issachar. But the tribes of Issachar had command, they had lead, they had headship, they had the upper hand, they led other tribes, because the other tribes lack understanding of the times, and because they didn't know what time it was, they didn't live according to the requirements of the time. When it is winter, it's a season that comes with specific requirements. You can't go around and dress in winter like you dress in summer, because the time or the season of winter, all season comes with their own demands. They come with their own requirements. So you can't go around dressing, wearing your summer outfit in the time of winter. It can't happen. And you can't wear a winter outfit in the time of the summer, because summer also comes with its own requirement. So just as there are seasons in the natural, there are also seasons in the spirit. Are you hearing me, somebody? And as spiritual people, we must find out, we gotta know how to log into the mind of God and to download the internal purposes of God. We gotta learn how to buy into the mind of God. We gotta learn how, as spiritual people, to have spiritual understanding, to know what time is it prophetically, what time is it spiritually. I was traveling the other day to a very important conference, and I missed my flight. I miscalculated my time. And so I got to the airport 30 minutes before my flight. And the lady said, I'm sorry, Archbishop, I can't help you. You should have been here 2 hours before. And I said, I have to make this flight. And she said, I'm sorry, you can't make it. You should have been here 2 hours before. All international flight, you should have been here 2 hours before. I did everything. This woman wouldn't budge. And the only reason why I missed that flight was because I miscalculated. I pray that we will not miscalculate spiritually. Are you hearing me, somebody? Because there are seasons and times in God when you miss it, that is it. Now, what is the time spiritually? Jesus said to the children of Israel, he said, because you know not the time of the season of your visitation, you will not see me again. Jesus said, I came to you. The Bible said that he came to his own, but his own received him not. And to the world he created, and the world knew him not, because they lacked the ability to discern the times. Somebody say, discern the times. One more time, say, descend the times. You see, the problem with the church is we just want to be refreshed. Now, the Bible talks about the times of refreshing. Say, the times of refreshing. Say it again. Say, the times of refreshing. But I want you to hear me, church. Hear me carefully. What God expects you and I to have when you leave this conference is not just refreshing. Everybody wants to be refreshed. But God's purpose is not for you and I to be refreshed. It goes beyond refreshing. He said, listen carefully. He said, Jesus, he will send Jesus Christ, who was preached to us before, whom the heavens must receive and keep him there until the restitution of all things prophesied, spoken by the mouth of God through his holy angels or holy prophet since the world began. Church, do you understand what the Bible is saying here? It means that Jesus ain't coming until the restitution of every prophetic word spoken by the mouth of his holy angels about you, about me, about the nations, about our world, about the church. It means that the heavens is going to keep him there until the restitution. No, look at me. There is a difference between restitution and restoration. Restoration is when you give me back what you took from me. Let's say you took $10,000 of my money 10 years ago and you give me back after 10 years the $20,000 of my money. That is restoration. But restitution is when you give me the $20,000 you took 10 years ago on today's market value. That means you make me whole. That means you bring me up to date. Are you hearing me, somebody? So that whatever, if $20,000 10 years ago on today's market value is $100,000, restitution means that you give me $100,000 and not $20,000. So God is taking the church from the place of restoration to the place of restitution. Are you hearing me, somebody? You didn't hear me. You didn't hear me. Wait a little bit, I'll get you. You are just used to shouting, but I want to put something in there. Hear me. The Bible said, if a thief be found, he is under obligation by law to give you sevenfold of what he took from you and all the substance of his house. You know what that is? That is not restoration. That is restitution. Are you hearing me, somebody? Say sevenfold. So say it again. Say sevenfold. He said, listen carefully. He said he is under obligation by law to give you sevenfold of what he took from you. Restoration is when he gives you back what he took. But restitution is when he gives it back to you over and beyond at the original value of what he took from you. Is anybody hearing me? This is not the day of restoration. It is the day of restitution. And the Bible said that Jesus is not coming until the restitution of everything. Every prophecy, everything written of you and I, Jesus is not returning here to the earth until restitution of all things. So I came to tell you, go past the place of refreshing. Refreshing and feeling good and good bounce is not what is here. God said, I want a restitution of everything that you should have been and you should have had right about now that you don't have. Is anybody hearing me? Come on, somebody. Somebody use the word, say restitution. Shout it, say restitution. Somebody said, this is my hour of restitution. And the Bible said that the heavens will keep Jesus there until, say until, say until, say until, say it again, say until the restitution of all things spoken by the mouth of God through his holy prophet since the world began, and until the restitution of all those stuff signed by God happens, Jesus will not be released by the heavens. And church, if we don't understand this, we just gonna live anyway, anyhow, and let anything just happen to our life. But if you are going to be able to experience restitution of whatever God intended your life to be originally, you got to begin to look at the time spiritually, look at the time prophetically, and not just live according to physical timing and timetable. You got to begin to understand Kairos times and Kairos moments. Are you hearing me, somebody? A Kairos time and a Kairos moment is a time and a minute in eternity when heaven stops. Are you hearing me? For restitution in the life of an individual. Are you hearing me, somebody? When the physical calendar time and the calendar of eternity comes into compliance and into alignment, and the lamplight is turned on somebody, and God said, this is your time of restitution, not just restoration. I am not living here for restoration. I want restitution. Are you hearing me, somebody? There are some stuff I should have had run about now that the devil took from me, and I don't want it back. I don't just want it back restored. I want to be right about now where I should have been, and I am not because of what the enemy did to me. Are you hearing me, somebody? You didn't hear me. Somebody say restitution. Use your word again, say restitution. One more time, say restitution. Look at me. When God brought the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt, restoration and restitution took place. Restoration was when their lives and their freedom to be free men and women was given back to them. That was restoration. But God went past restoration to restitution. Why? It wasn't just restoring their freedom and their liberty by bringing them out of captivity. But the Bible said, ladies and gentlemen, God gave them all the substance of the land of Egypt. God literally bankrupted the economy of the wicked and the land of Egypt, and they left the land of Egypt with great substance. Not that only, but with the promise of a nation they didn't build, with the promise of a land that flows with milk and honey, with the promise of houses they did not build and vineyard they did not plant. Is anybody hearing me? Shout the word restitution. One more time, shout the word restitution. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the moment and the hour of restitution. And the people that will experience restitution are men and women who understands divine timings and seasons and timetable. You got to know what time it is spiritually. You got to know what time is it prophetically. What is this hour? What is this time? Because if you don't know it, you can shout all you want to. You can scream all you want to and still miss out. out because you did not know the times of your visitation. And of the sons of Issachar, who were men that had understanding. Somebody say understanding, understanding. Say understanding, understanding. Oh, understanding be my portion. Understanding. Understanding of the times. The times. Then the Bible talks about the times of refreshing. Then he goes further to say this Jesus. He will send Jesus who was preached to you before. But the heavens will keep him until the restitution of all the prophecies that has been spoken since the world began. Since the world began. Which means that God has something for you. There is something written of you and I in the books of eternity, and heaven will not release Jesus from the right hand of the Father until the things that have been declared of you and I before we came into our mother's womb comes into reality, and not just to pass. But God said, you know why there's going to be restitution? Because God said there have been too many delays, too many interference, too many frustrations and disappointment in the lives of my people. God said certain stuff should have happened right about now. That has not happened. And it's going to take more than restoration. So what I'm going to do is to give them restitution and not just restoration. Are you hearing me, somebody? That's why the Bible said, for your shame, I will give you double. Say double, 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 double. Double here is not restoration. Double here is restitution. Because restoration is when I lose my honor and my honor is given back to me. That is restoration. Job lost 10 kids, 9 months, and nothing did happen until he prayed. And when Job prayed, God didn't just restore. He gave him twice as much as he had before. That was restitution. It wasn't restoration. Come on, somebody, talk to me. Somebody say restitution. Somebody say restitution. Please hear me carefully. Look at me. The Bible said, the devil cometh not but to kill, to steal, and to destroy. Amen. But I have come that ye may have what? Life. That is restoration. I have come that ye may have what? Life. That is what? Restoration. But Jesus wasn't dealing with restoration, Bishop. He was dealing with restitution. He said, I have come that you may have life, restoration, have it more abundantly. That is restitution. Are you hearing me, somebody? So he said, whatever the devil took from you and destroyed, I'm going to give it to you and over and beyond and above what you had before. That is restitution. So church, look at me. I want you to hear me carefully. Church, the Bible says, Jesus, whom the heavens must receive, means keep him there until the restitution, Bishop, of all things spoken by the mouth of God through his holy prophet since the world began. It means that Jesus is not coming today, nor coming tomorrow, until the restitution of all things, because God cannot lie. Did you hear what I said? He cannot walk. He cannot walk. He cannot walk. He cannot walk. Now sit down. Give me 2 minutes. Give me 2 minutes. Hear me. Hear me. Look at me. Hear me. You gotta get this. You gotta get this. Hear me carefully. When God made promise to Abraham, the Bible said there was none greater by whom he could swear. So God said, I've looked to the heavens above. I am the El Elyon. There is none above me. I've gone to the north, the east. I've gone to the past, to the regions of the sea and the underworld, and the five regions of the underworld. And there is none above me. I am that I am. I am all that you ever need. I am. I am peace. I am joy. I am power. I am wisdom. I am knowledge. I am understanding. I am everything. and there is none above me. So the Bible said God sworn by himself that I swear by myself. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the oath, and the oath is greater than the promise, because it is the oath that guarantees the promise. And what is the oath? The oath is that God cannot lie. And that's why there has to be restitution of all things before he comes. Nothing can be left undone, because if anything is left undone and unfulfilled, the accuser has the right to accuse the justice of heaven, and God cannot be accused. And therefore Jesus had to be held back until the restitution of all things since the world began. So stop talking to me about restoration. This is not the moment of restoration. This is the hour of restitution. Are you hearing me, somebody? Now, look at something. The Bible said, you know why, Bishop, a lot of folks don't give? And people give the way they give carelessly. And they hold back a lot from God. They don't understand restitution. Hear me. The Bible says, give, and it shall be given. Restoration. Good measure, beyond restoration. Press down, shake it together, run it over. Shall men, that is not restoration, that is restitution. Are you hearing me, somebody? Restoration is give, and it shall be what? Given. Restoration. Good measure, above restoration. Press down, shake it together, run it over. Shall men, restitution. Is anybody hearing me? Abraham gave one son, Isaac, put him on the altar. And God said, because of what thou hast done, God said, your seed shall be like the stars of heaven, which refers to you and I, sitting in heavenly places. And then there are two seeds here, stars of heaven representing you and I, the church. Then as the sand of the seashore, that is representing his natural seed, Israel. Are you hearing me? Didn't stop there. When Sarah died, Abraham remarried. Married a woman by the name of Keturah. And God gave him 5 sons from Keturah. He gave one Isaac. He had all the stars of heaven. He had natural seed on the earth. He also had 5 more sons, but gave one. That is restitution. The last move to precede the coming of the Lord will be intercession. Because there will not be, hear me carefully, there will not come restitution without intercession. And it will take intercession to bring restitution, to release the heavens, to bring him back. Hear me. Prayer is the only acceptable medium exchange or currency that is accepted in heaven for exchange of everything we need in heaven. Now, when Daniel saw Jeremiah prophecy of the 70 years captivity, Jeremiah 29:10, the Bible said, and he began to fast, to pray according to that word, and the prophetic word was activated. Say activated. Use the word, say activated. I command your prophetic word to be activated right now. I activate the word of the Lord over your life. I activate your blessing right now. I activate your destiny right now. Sit down, give me 2 minutes. Now, look at me. When the prophetic word was activated, church, look at me. When the prophetic word was activated, it activated God, angels, and the devil. God was activated, angels was activated, the prince of the kingdom of Persia was activated by the prophetic word. You know why the devil is fighting you? It's not because of you, it's because of your prophetic word. Because he knows, you know why the devil don't want you to pray? Because he knows when you begin to pray, you will activate your prophetic word. When the word is activated, God will be activated. It will activate everything around you. So the devil wants you to do every odd that thing back to pray. Because prayer activates the prophetic word, and the prophetic word activates God, and at the same time exposes the enemy. See now, 2 minutes. The Bible said, when Lot departed from Abraham, God came and said, Abraham, now, say now, say now. He said, now lift up thine eyes from where thou art and see, look everywhere, see what I have had for you all this time along. See it now from where you are. You don't have to leave where you are to see it. Just where you are, see it. You know what God was saying? God said, Abraham, all this time around, you could have seen this, but you couldn't see it because your eyes were blinded. The word Lot means a veil. Lot means a veil. Say a veil. Say a veil. Until the veil was removed, Abraham couldn't see. Are you hearing me? There are some stuff in your life. There are some people in our lives. Until they are removed, there are things God has in store we can never see, and we will never see until we call upon the Lord and say, Lord, what is this that I'm dealing with? And God said, let me remove the veil so you can see. Until Lot goes, and Lot can be anything. That's why Jesus said the other day, if your right hand troubles you, cut it off. It means that Lot can even be your right hand to stop you from coming into your destiny and fulfilling your eternal destiny. Right now, I need everybody to hold somebody's hands and lift it up. Don't stand. Sit down. Sit down. Lift it up. No movement around. I want us to cry out to God right now that the veil will be removed, that the obstacles will be removed, that the prophetic word will be activated, because this is the hour of restitution, not restoration, restitution. Open your mouth, pray through right now. Somebody cry out, somebody cry out, somebody cry out. Will answer. God said, I haven't answered because you haven't cried out. Somebody cry out. Somebody cry out. I need somebody to cry out right now. Somebody cry out. He said, I will answer. I will show you the veil, that which has bewitched you, that which has hindered you. I will show you. I will show you. I will reveal. I will uncover. I will remove the covering. Somebody cry out. 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 Hey! Somebody cry out. Something is happening. Cry out. Cry out. One more prayer. 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 Cry out. One more prayer.
Inspiration is sponsored by Budget Cash and Carry, official distributors of Hallelujah Non-Alcoholic Sparkling Wine.
Have you read that has changed your life? Visit Dominion Bookshop and discover a unique collection of life-transforming books, including The Price of Greatness, Divine Timing, Destined to Make an Impact, and lots more, all written by Archbishop Duncan Williams. Also in stock are other great books authored by men of God with great experiences that would impact your life. Dominion Bookshop is located at the Prayer Cathedral, Christian Action Faith Ministries International, off the Sprinters Road.
Praise the Lord. From the Archbishop Duncan Williams, you can now receive inspirational calls and SMS on your mobile phones wherever you may be.
How? Tell me more.
Just subscribe to receive daily messages on your mobile phones by texting Ariba 1486, OneTouch 1686, Kasapa 1786, and Tigo 1886.
Join the family now, because your future is in the making.
Bless you. Be inspired. Be motivated. Unlock your potential and walk into your destiny.